a galaxy unimaginably distant from ours, on a planet called Fester Osiris, there arose a race so powerful that they became like gods. As well as mastering technology and science, the Osirians developed powers of pure thought, bending the physical world to their will by the strength of their minds alone. As they grew in power, so they grew in wisdom, all but one. His name was Sutekh, and he was great among the Osirians. But greater still was his brother Horus, who all Osirians called leader. All but Sutekh, who hated Horus and was jealous of him. The Osirians spread throughout the galaxies of the cosmos. They ruled many worlds and were often worshipped as gods. But Sutekh stayed on Fester Osiris, their own planet, working to develop his powers so that he might one day overthrow his brother Horus. The Osirians were a long-lived race. Sutekh worked and studied for thousands of years until his powers were truly awe-inspiring. But his mind was full of jealousy and hatred, and in time this turned to madness. Overmastered by his own fears, Sutekh became convinced that not only the other Osirians, but all sentient life was his mortal enemy. Not just the more intelligent life forms, but animals, reptiles, insects, plants. Sutekh hated them all. He feared someday somewhere there might evolve a life form powerful enough to destroy him. An insane ambition formed in Sutekh's twisted mind. He would range through the galaxies and destroy all life until only he remained as unchallenged ruler. He became Sutekh the Destroyer, and he began by destroying his own planet. Leaving the shattered desolation of Fester Osiris behind him, Sutekh blazed a trail of havoc across the cosmos, wrecking and smashing world after world with his titanic powers. Soon, news of his madness reached fellow Osirians. Led by Horus, they began to search for Sutekh, determined to destroy him. Tracking him by his trail of destruction, they hunted him across the cosmos. At last, Sutekh took refuge on an obscure planet called Earth, and here, finally, his fellow Osirians found him. The battle was long and fierce, for Sutekh was a formidable opponent. 740 Osirians came to Earth to combine against him, before he was finally defeated and made captive in a land called Egypt. They brought him before his brother Horus for judgment. Many urged that all the Osirians should link their minds and blast Sutekh from existence, but Horus would not agree. To kill Sutekh would mean that they too were destroyers. Horus decreed that Sutekh should not die, but should be made eternally captive. A pyramid was built to become his prison, and since more than walls of stone were needed to imprison such a being as Sutekh, he was locked in the grip of a mighty force field, paralyzed and utterly helpless. For even greater safety, the control point of this pyramid was placed not on Earth, but on one of the other planets circling its sun. On Earth, a secret cult of Egyptian priests was set up to guard the pyramid. Satisfied that Sutekh was forever bound, Horus and the other Osirians went on their way. What became of the Osirians, no one can say. They vanished from our cosmos and were seen no more. On Earth, they left behind them legends of the all-powerful gods who fought wars among themselves. Deep inside the pyramid, Sutekh lived on. For thousands upon thousands of years, he endured his long captivity. Bound by the force field of Horus, scarcely able to move a muscle, only his twisted brain was active. It planned and plotted without cease, waiting for the day of his escape. For Horus would not leave even Sutekh quite without hope. He had told him that escape was possible, though the difficulties and obstacles were so great as to be almost insurmountable. The mighty civilization of Egypt rose and fell. Other civilizations and empires took its place. Sutekh and Horus and the Osirians were remembered only as a legend. Still, Sutekh waited in his hidden pyramid until one day.